Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you how to play Jar of Hearts by Christina Perry, and this is a request. But first of all, please check out the cover I did of this with Emily, which is all good, you know, and comment, rate, subscribe, and request. Okay, so, yeah, I haven't done a tutorial in a while, I'm sorry. I'm kind of now on a gap here, and I'm basically working and personal statement writing, and I can assure you my life is totally fun at the moment. I mean, I just watched X Factor, like, judges' houses, so, you know, why wouldn't my life be fun? Anyway, apart from that, so Jar of Hearts, you're going to need a capo on one. What I would say about this song is if you want to play it along with the CD and then you want to sit there and go, hell yeah, I can play this song well, don't choose this song. I mean, because I haven't really been able to find a strumming a vaguely exciting strumming pattern that goes with it, or a picking pattern that actually fits with the CD. So if you say, I don't know, you're looking to do like a very cool, trendy acoustic cover, go for this song. But if you want to play along with the CD, do not waste your breath. Or, well, I suppose if you're going to sing. But don't waste, you know, your fingers. And let your glucose, you know, for respiration for your fingers. I mean, because, let's face it, you can use it on better things than playing a song which with a strumming pattern that I give you that doesn't really fit. Anyway, so for this song, you're going to need quite a few chords today. You're going to need a B minor, D, A, E minor, G, G minor, F sharp, or F sharp minor, I don't know actually what it is, but... and E. So out of those chords, I'm going to assume you know how to play D, A, E minor, G, and E. So if you know how to play those chords, skip ahead. If you don't, keep watching. So B minor, high string, string one, low E string, string six. Not really feeling the sound of my... Sorry, I think I totally need to change the strings. Anyway, so B minor, you bar the second fret with your first finger, all the strings. Then you put your middle finger on the second string, third fret, your ring finger on the fourth string, fourth fret, and your first finger on the third string, fourth fret. Okay, next chord we've got a G minor. I have to say, I don't really like G minor, if I'm honest, because I can't really play it very well. Oof, yuck. I don't like it at all. Anyway, there are probably a couple of ways around playing G minor, but I have to say I'm a little bit lazy and I haven't yet looked them up. So feel free to look them up. But the version I'm going to show you today, you bar at the third string, the third fret with your first finger. You put your ring finger on the fifth string, fifth fret, and your little finger on the fourth string, fifth fret. I'm quite impressed with that G minor, actually. Oh, pat on the back for me. Anyway, okay, then the last chord is F sharp. It's either F sharp minor or F sharp. If I'm honest, I don't really know, because I can never tell the difference. I think it's F sharp minor. Anyway, so what you do, you can either play it this like full bar version, but I've already said, you know, I'm a lazy little toad, and I like to cheat playing bar chords. So what you do, you bar the first three strings of the second fret with your first finger, and you put your little finger on the fourth string, fourth fret. And voila, kind of F sharp minor, but to be honest, it kind of sounds the same. And you only play it, like in the bridge, that's it, so you can't really tell. Okay, so for this song, you've got three different chord patterns to learn. You've got the first one for the verse. So what you do is you hold each of these chords for four beats. So you've got a B minor, a D, an A, and an E minor, all for four beats. Then that kind of repeats, except the last chord you play isn't an E minor, it's a G. So then you've got a B minor, a D, an A, and then a G. So B minor, D, A, E minor, B minor, D, A, G. Lovely. Anyway, so then the bit you've come to is the bit that goes, I've learned to live half life. And this is where the kind of counting gets a little bit confusing. But, you know, as long as you can count to four, the world is happy. Happy days, you know. Okay, so you've got an E minor for four beats. And then you've got a D for two beats and an A for two beats. Then you've got an E minor for two beats, a D for two beats, and an A for four. So basically it's like the same counting, but backwards the second time. So E minor, two, three, four. D, 2, A, 2, E minor, 2, D, 2, A, A, 2, 3, 4. I might have said A minor during that. I meant E minor, I'm sorry. But you know, check out the boxes on my head and I shall write it out there. Okay, so strumming pattern wise, what I'd recommend for this song, well, for this verse at any rate, you know, because it's kind of setting an atmosphere and she kind of changes like the tempo parts, it's kind of really hard to put a strumming pattern to it. So I would literally just recommend just, you know, down strums and, you know, put a kind of, I don't know, like pain stricken look on your face sort of thing, which sadly I'm not going to do for you today. But yeah. Then you get to the chorus. This is a bit that goes, who do you think you are? And it gets quite exciting, I have to say, at this point. You can bring in, I would say, a vague strumming pattern. Very vague, but, you know, it's there nonetheless. Anyway, so the chord pattern for this chord, for this chorus, you've got a D, an A B minor, then you've got a G for two beats, a G minor for two beats, and then a D. I was impressed with that G minor again. I am on a roll. It's amazing. Anyway, so you play that entire chord pattern twice, and you hold the G for two beats and the G minor for two beats. Now this vague strumming pattern, so... down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down. So all it is just down, down, down on each chord, and then when you're going to change, just down, up, change chord. And then back to the down again. So what I'll do is I'll quickly play that through with the song for you. And I'm sorry, it's kind of quiet. So, you know, sing along if you know the words. You know, and that's amazing. Oops, a bit late there. You lost the love, I love the love. Da da da. Quite like that bit. D for two, A for two, E minor for two, D for two, A for four, and the strumming pattern begins now. I'm sorry, that wasn't kind of strummed very well. I wasn't particularly happy with that. Anyway, then you've got another verse, exactly the same. Then you come to the bridge, and this is the bit that goes, it took so long for me to feel alright? It to feel alright? I don't know. Anyway, so you hold each of these chords for two beats. You've got a B minor, then an F sharp, and then a D, and then an E. And then that repeats four times. So B minor, F sharp, D, E, all held for two beats, that repeats four times. And then you've got the bit that goes, okay, I can't remember the words, but whatever. Just, you play that four times, and then you've got a G for four beats, and then F sharp for four beats, and then you go back to the G for four beats, and then the F sharp for four beats. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just quickly find that on the track and play it for two. Well, I've never actually watched this music video, but it looks a little bit depressing. Anyway. G, F sharp. It's awful. Anyway, then back to the chorus. So basically, that's the entire song. So please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request. I have to say, it has occurred to me, I have kind of been dissing the song like the entire video. But yeah, you know, it's a cool song. I mean, it's not one of my favourites, but I like her voice. She's got a cool voice. But I quite like happy songs. Well, I say happy, but like Simple Plan. Totally immense. Taylor Swift, also totally immense. But no, it's a cool song, and I do have it on my iPod, but it's just not one of my favourites. Okay, so yeah, check out the cover that I did, please. That'd be lovely. With Emily, and in that one, I was kind of doing picking. So basically, the thing with the picking is the only thing that changes with each chord you play is the first string you pluck. So let's call that string X. Then the next bit you play would be string 4, and then 2 and 3 together. And then you play 4 again. So you got X, 4, 2 and 3, 4, X, 4, 2 and 3, 4. Okay, so for B minor, the first string you play is string 5. For D, I play D slash F sharp. So that means you bring your thumb round and you put it on the 2nd fret 6th string. So that gives you an F sharp in the bass. Then the first string I pluck for that one is string 6. Then the first string I pluck for A is the 5th string. And for E minor is the 5th string again. Sorry, so that probably makes no sense. Okay, then I think I kind of covered all that. Then G minor, I pluck the 6th string. Then for F sharp minor, I pluck the 5th string. Then for E, once again, the 5th string. Okay, so I'm sorry, if you haven't watched the cover or any of my tutorials, it's kind of like the same picking pattern I do for most of it. But yeah, I find the picking pattern like works a bit better for me because I prefer picking strumming. But yeah. Who do you think you are? Running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. Don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? Anyways, that's just the chorus with the picking, but yeah, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request. My lesson for the day, seeing as, you know, like I said before, I'm kind of on a gap here, so I'm not learning anything at the moment, which, if I'm honest, is a little bit depressing, and I think my brain might kind of, like, I don't know, turn to, like, go and melt out my ear, you know, which would be depressing, but I wouldn't have a brain, so I wouldn't actually feel depressed. I imagine it just feel, like, empty, which would be fun, but, you know, there wouldn't be any, like, neurons to kind of go to your brain. Oh, I have an idea. Okay, so right. Sensory neurons. Oh god, I can't remember which round it goes. Okay, sensory neurons carry, like, the nerve impulse from, like, the... Oh my god, what's it called? The effector? From the receptor, that's the one. This is awful. Anyway, so sensory neurons carry the impulse from the receptor to the central nervous system, like, which is also known as your spine, like where your spinal cord. And then a relay neuron carries the impulse from, like, one bit of the spinal cord to the other bit of the spinal cord, where it's then kind of, like, passes the impulse onto a motor neuron, which then, you know, like, kind of zaps the impulse down to the effector. Sort of thing, which is like either a muscle or a gland. So for example, if, say, I don't know, like, you're burning your finger in a candle, like, the cells in your finger would kind of go, oh my god, I'm being burned, I'm dying, and then the sensory neuron would kick in, da da da, relay neuron, central nervous system, blah blah blah, blah. And then the motor neuron would come back down, and that would probably, I don't know, like, the receptor then would be your muscle, because either then, I don't know, you'd swear, or you'd kind of whip your finger out of the way, or if you, like, fire, you'd kind of hold it there, which would be a bit of a bummer. Like, fingerless. That'd be a nightmare. Anyway, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request.